वेलकम टू एनबीसी न्यूज। यू आर वॉचिंग इंग्लिश बुलेटिन विथ रत्नाकर। द न्यूज इन डिटेल। Maltier ASI Badole was cremated with full state honors in the presence of a large number of dignitaries, family members, neighbors, and CRPF personnel who bid a tearful adieu to the gallant officer. The CRPF Jawan gave a gun salute to the martyr with citizens raised patriotic slogans on the occasion. Later, the coffin carrying his mortal remains was carried to the crematorium in a vehicle decorated with flowers. Dignitaries like Home Minister Anil Deshmukh, Guardian Minister Dr. Nitin Rao, Resident Deputy Collector Rajendra Hajaji, Mr. Krupal Tumane, MLA Samir Mege, Commandant of CRPF Subhash Chandra, Sanjay Kumar, Deputy Inspector General of Police Sanjay Latkar, Inspector General of Police, DCP Traffic, and other paid tribute to the martyr. Home Minister Deshmukh and other leaders visited the slain officer's residence earlier and consoled his wife Pramila and daughters Mrunal and Pratnya. Finding out that remdesivir injection is being used rapidly while treating COVID-19 patients, Maharashtra Public Health Minister Rajesh Tope said that after talking to several medicos, he has reached the conclusion that the injections need not to be used for every COVID-19 patient. It is very effective, but doctors should maintain rationality while using the injection to treat such patients. The government will soon come up with the guidelines for the use of these injections. Tope was addressing media persons in the Divisional Commissioner's office on Friday. Medical Education Minister Amit Deshmukh, Home Minister Anil Deshmukh, FD Minister Dr. Rajendra Singhne, Tope had earlier taken stock of the situation in Bhandara and Gondia districts. On Friday, the delegation of minister also interacted with the dean and other officials of the GMCH and carried out assessment of the prevailing COVID-19 situation in the district. Parampujya Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar Smarak Samiti has cancelled Dhamma Chakra Pravartan Din program held annually at Dikshabhumi on October 14 and Ashok Vijay Dashami due to COVID-19 pandemic. Dr. Sudhir S. Guljwale, secretary of the Samiti, stated in a press release issued on Friday that all the functions in Dikshabhumi stood cancelled. The infection of COVID-19 is spread fast in Nagpur and many other places in the vicinity. In view of the same stringent implementation and observance of guidelines issued by the government and local administration, it's must in order to avoid spread the virus among millions of visitors at Dikshabhumi. The possibility of a few corona-positive individuals in the crowd of visitors infecting millions of others cannot be ruled out. Hence, the Smarak Samiti has appealed to the people to stay at home on October 14 and October 25 and offer Buddha Vandana from home itself. Amidst dwindling revenue due to coronavirus pandemic-induced economic slumps, the ruling body at Nagpur Municipal Corporation has written to the state government and asked for a special grant of Rs. 500 crores for completing of ongoing development works and coronavirus pandemic containment efforts in the city. Vijay Jhalki, the chairperson of the standing committee, has sent a letter to Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray in this regard and requested speedy provision of the financial grant. Jhalki said that in the fight against COVID-19, NMC's revenue has been stretched to the limit. Now, to contend for the speed of the pandemic, the civic body outreach needs financial backup as its own covers are nearly empty. Due to lack of revenue, the development work in the city has also come to a standstill, thereby causing immense problems for the citizens. On Friday night, an elderly saloon owner was brutally killed by three suspects with sticks. The deceased has been identified as Sudesh Hansraj Thul. Due to some commitments, Thul opened his saloon in evening instead of morning, so there were customers were already waiting for haircut. Two of the accused had come to the saloon for a haircut. As customers were already present, Thul asked them to wait for some time, following which the accused started abusing him. The quarrel quickly went out of control, and on hearing the commotion, another complainant joined them. Soon a fight commenced and the trio dragged Thul out of the saloon and brutally beat him with sticks and then fled the scene. Some onlookers took him to a nearby hospital where doctors declared him brought dead. Inspector Santosh Bakal and his team soon traced and arrested the accused trio. As many as 41 persons succumbed to COVID-19 on Friday. With this, the cumulative death toll in the district has now reached to 2,302. On the other hand, 1,318 persons have gone home after recovery and obtaining permission from medical authorities. With this, the total number of recovered patients in the district is now 54,806, including patients who have recovered during home isolation and treatment. The recovery rate of the district is now at 75.18%. The total corona positive cases tally of Nagpur district is now at 72,899 with 971 positive cases coming to light in the last 24 hours. While giving a breakup of the deaths, medical officials revealed that out of the total casualties, 390 and 1,693 victims are from the rural and urban areas of the district respectively, while as many as 290 persons are from outside Nagpur district. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBC News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very good care of yourself.